Hello. I thought that was forward. We made a terrifying angry frog. Added that so it looked less like it. I'm not super happy with that right there, but I'm not gonna care about it at the moment. We need to finish these walls. Once we finish the walls, we can work on the little cubbies, which will also probably be up here. But, I think the first thing I want to do is come over here. Grab some lanterns and stuff. And then we'll, Over here. Boy, do you have a problem? Well then, shut up. I don't care. At the moment, that is what it is going to be, and you are going to deal with it. No, then go away. So that's there. I think we got pretty good stuff there. Oh, well. Okay.
Let's build the walls!
Which are pretty much only gonna have this design along them. And that's about it. go next to this. Put a full block above that, which I might change into like one of these. Okay. We have that, we have that, and we have that. Okay, so like S's. So that's like that. So now this is like that. Two blocks. Then another one of the C's. Except I put it the wrong way. Okay. Okay, so we've begun another one. I need to get more of those blocks. Yeah, hopefully this short episode will end the majority of this. Like, that looks really horribly ugly, but I don't know what to do with it, so I have something set up there for the moment. We might do something with it. We might just leave it, because I really just want to get off the exterior and get to the interior in the weird creature's mouth. Okay. still need to figure out what to do with this part of the staircase too. Yeah, I'm just like all over the place. Start the pattern again. Here, followed by I'll need more stairs now too. Place all of these. And some of these builds in this world and stuff will be actually being used for our Minecraft animation series. I'm actually in the middle of writing a prologue type book, Minecraft book, but I'm making it not directly reference Minecraft constantly, like with all the blocks and stuff, or the respawn net beds. In fact, pretty much I think the narrative is going to be there is no respawning, because respawning in Minecraft animations and books is kind of cheap. Have a pointless disaster, pointless character death that doesn't actually do anything. But yeah, so I'm just gonna go build this all the way up down, so that as we go it's much easier. Building all of that was a pain. I was kinda just placing blocks in random spots. While we're over at this side, I need to go get stairs. What we do? Oh wait, no, we do S's next. My own pattern is complicated, and I'm leaving the stone exposed behind because it's extra texture and because I don't want to bother placing blocks behind it. These are the closest we're getting to the carved patterns and stuff. And see, these are still perfect spaces to fit these doorways in. We're just threading details above instead of doing that. Which, that would be much simpler, but I don't know. I'm just going with complicated stuff for no reason, really. Okay, and then... Wait, is that it? Or... No. No blocks yet. Now we're doing that. Really, this is the most random pattern in the world, and it doesn't have an actual end, it seems. Because instead of doing like this again, which actually probably would be better, it's like a not, it's not the same on both sides. Let me double check if that's right for like the bazillionth time. Yes, that is right. Okay, I think I have most of the pattern. Pretty much memorized now. Mom, that sounds horribly morbid. Yeah, it was a joke, but it was like a dark humor joke. Thought you didn't like that. She dropped the book about the girl on the high wire, and then she said, "Oh no, she, like whatever her name is, fell off the high wire." That's a dark joke. Wait, is this? Yes, that is right. Except the fact that it's not perfect, because I'm pretty sure the pattern started, yeah, there. So what does this exactly mean? Like, it pretty much means that this is one block off. However, this is the entrance, so I guess it's not a big deal. However, dirt is not allowed. All leave perfect areas to make the little doorway things. Or not. Did I get the pattern off? Yeah, I got. How did I do that? Did I do the pattern right and then fail it the rest of the way? Which may or may not fix the pattern, but it does mean I have to redo it. Like, a lot of pain. his back. What a lovely pain. Then we do that. Then we do that. Which means this gets moved. This is a no fun thing to do. Boom. Never mind, I just tore down the one that was supposed to be there. See, this is the kind of anti-productive kind of stuff that I end up doing because I just can't concentrate or think. Okay, stone there. Dirt not needed. These aren't really needed. Kind of needed. We need more of these. These are the ones that need taken down. Okay, we still do need these. Boom, 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 boom. It's a really weird pattern. Really, I should, like, make it better, but, why do that when I could be stupid? And arrogant, no, that's not even a word. I can't speak. That's the one I put it to. Let's double check we didn't mess this up. Yeah. Ooh, not like that. I think this is gonna actually end up making this actually correct in its pattern spacing. Yeah, looks like it. Yeah. Well, actually, let me see. Please work out, because otherwise I'll be very sad. I think it works. Yep, it fits. Beautiful. I don't know where I came up with this genius idea for depth decoration, but I don't know how to do this. I build basic Minecraft blockhouses that sometimes vary into slightly cool territory. Still looks like a prison of some sort, but like an Aztec sacrifice prison. The worst kind of prison. But yeah, we've gotten one side done. There's another side to do. How painful is that? On resources, and we'll tackle the other side. And that will probably be the end of a shorter episode. Okay. Stairs. Gonna need a lot more of these blocks. So, yeah. I don't need slabs anymore, so I'm gonna put those away. I don't need all of this. I only need like one stack. I need iron. came on this part like I did on the other side, and then led the stairs last. Jumpist is really good for building, just not many people use it because it is annoying when you're not building. Or in general. Jumpist is kind of like a cool effect, but it's not very useful. At least that's what people say, but I think it's great. You know, I don't really know why I got the second beacon to get jump boost to begin with, but it worked out because it has helped me go through this a lot faster. Just adding extra holes into the walls so I stay on track. I already know it's going to end like this. Real quick side quest to get rid of this horrible, ugly, offensive block. Dirt. It burned it. Perfect. Did I do this right? No, wait, did I? Beginning of the pattern is here. And Yes, we did it right. Yep, it's right on, so yeah. Bruh, music, why you have to die? These will look better when they're sitting there looking ugly because they don't match it. So, yeah, that. Wait. What? No, wait. I didn't mess this up, right? No. Where did I mess this up? I messed this up somewhere. I had to have. No, not that beginning. Where did I mess up? How did I mess up? That's that. Oh wait, no, I just put this in the right spot. Okay, I'm an idiot. floors to decorate with. Just need like some more, yeah, surface, like iron. I'm completely filling this in when I literally need to dig into those spots, but oh well. Nice. So now the only thing that kind of needs light is right here, so I might actually keep the lanterns here. I might put them like here. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's there. Maybe I should put the lanterns here. I don't know. It looks better than it did. Yeah, I'm full. Right. Yeah. Walk up here, and this will open the door. Which, the door might shrink a bit, so I can add like a cool piston door, rather than just like an iron door. I'll also need to look up a tutorial for that. Like, you can tell it's lava down there, but not very well. A little bit of eyesore slash pain, because like, yeah, just ruins the pillars, but oh well. I think that is the interior designs finished. We can add rooms and start on the dungeon. We might add more of these, like I might add redstone lamps into the ceiling with the same type of design I did there. I'm gonna need to move this beacon into behind that cave wall thing, I think. Here we go. Perfect. A single block of dirt. Can't go there. Okay. That is pretty nice. For now, I'm literally just gonna take this down, because I don't wanna have to worry about that. Not right now. If David insists that it's horribly ugly, then he can do something with it. But I should wait. Actually, I might be losing some of this stuff to like those landing on that. Oh no. We have our explorer with his magical wizard staff. I don't know if I like that stuff. We have our warrior. still don't know what to do behind here. Maybe I should do this part. This would be a great spot for the shop, at least. But, Should've had Save grab me a few villager spawn outs or something. Maybe we could just lead some villagers in here. Be like shopkeepers or something. I should have grabbed more slabs. I'm gonna lower the behind the desk type. There we are. You know, so if we trap anything in here, it'll look half decent. Put these on the corners. Yeah, the bars connect to them, but no. It's okay. Still need jump boost. So you can get in and out as of the jump boost. But the villager, whoever I'll put in here, maybe just a mob or something. Yeah, I'll put a warden in here. Anyway, yeah. They'll just be there, you know, a shopkeeper or something. Like, why do I even dig in the ground? I could just do something above. Make it so they can't get out. That would like look so much better. And this thing might actually look better if I put it over here. Like, maybe one here. Or one here. Like one there. I'm just going to keep it as is for the moment, and I'll have a shop here, you know. It's a very small area, but still, it's going to look cool. The dungeon shop. Woo! I'm so hyped to be almost done with this. Like, the major parts are done. And, like, this thing will be a little bit of a mess. But, yeah, we'll add different rooms along here. If I could figure out how to make, like, a key type system where hoppers only accept a certain block or something, I could literally give everyone key cards so that they are the only people that have access to their areas. Yeah, if I could get some cool redstone doors, that would be awesome, but that's unlikely, so I'm just gonna make one for like this. I'll probably shorten this like that way, and then add like blocks there. You know, something. And then I'll have like a little piston door, which is, yeah. Just need to figure out how to get that to work. Oh, I'm so hype. I'm so excited. Woo! So yeah, if you like get this part out of the way, like here. The dungeon. That will be the door. Which, also, making a redstone signal underneath this thing might require me blocking this area off, so this might not be the shop. This might just be blocked off. Yeah, that's all for this episode. That was medium length, I'd say. But yeah, thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.